Miss Shannon, B Rights here, producer Trey, me, Tony Fly, and Alonzo Bodden. What's going on,
What's
man?
What's up? What's How up? How you guys doing?
I love the show Last Comic Standing, even my Miss Shannon.
Man, you guys are hard on Shannon. I was listening to Coming In. Wow. Shannon's going to shoot me while I'm here.
Alonzo, winner of season 3 on Last Comic Standing and now judge of the current season.
Now, do you remember Shannon's audition and the performance at the showcase?
I do not remember Shannon's material, but I remember Shannon being there, and Shannon did well. You know, it was tough, and you picked a rough city to audition in. Minneapolis was the hardest city for us to pick from because they had too many good comics here.
So are we just very funny people?
Yeah.
Is that what it is?
Yeah, I don't know. Maybe it's because you locked in all winter.
Maybe. Yeah. We're all at home writing material.
I don't know. Maybe there's something out on one of them 10,000 lakes. I don't know what it is. Seriously, this was a hilarious city. We were surprised. Like, wow, this is going to be really hard to pick because there were so many good comics here.
Alonzo, I will be honest with you. The day that I auditioned and I made it to the finals that night, I walked into the room and I was just overwhelmed by the people who were there. Because it's all people that I have been looking forward to being able to open for one day. And they all have Comedy Central specials.
Some people are under the impression this show's for rookies, like we're trying to discover. It's like, oh, no, this is people who've been doing it a long time who finally get their shot, you know. And you were joking about working in the VFWs and the fire stations.
Right.
That's where you get funny. It is easy to be funny at Acme on Saturday night. But when you got a Tuesday night in a bowling alley in Billings, Montana,
right?
I'm serious. That's where you better be funny. I've worked roadhouses in Texas. Now you that's where your life depends on being funny. They got guns, they got rope, they got pickup trucks. So you could be funny, or your career can come to a grinding halt right now.
Are you following the Paris Hilton story at all?
Well, first of all, there are things I'd like to say, but this is not satellite radio. So I cannot give my truest opinion. This is what I think about Paris Hilton being the lead story on the news throughout the United States of America. The United States of America now needs adult supervision.
Yeah.
That was proof that we're done. We're done. We've become the idiot country of the world, and we need to be stopped. We need to be watched. Canada needs to check on us periodically. There's nothing you can say. See, this is where being a comic, it's like, what can you say that's funnier than actually watching it happen? There's no way. Paris, it's like, you've seen stupid. We've all seen stupid. But this is a whole new level.
Yeah.
This is a world. She has no contact at all with the real world. And Larry King, how much do they pay you to sit there and do that? Like, I don't know how much he gets paid. I don't know if, like, maybe he just took some dope and was out of it and said, I'm just going to read this. Because you can't be an intelligent person and hold a conversation with her and not want to leap across the table and just smack her in the head. Right? So I'm actually becoming a Paris fan. They've beaten me into, you asked for my opinion. I'm not going to shut up. No, you asked for this.
Now you love her because
they have beaten me down to the point where I am a fan and I'm pushing for Paris Hilton for president in 2012. Now, here's why. You laugh, right? 30 years ago, when George Bush was drunk and coked out and said, I want to be president, people said, you're crazy. And look what happened.
He's the president.
So why not Paris? But let's not wait 30 years. Let's just do it right now.
Cut to the chase.
Let's just do it right now. I was with Barack Obama until Monday.
So last night on Larry King, on this fluffy softball interview of Larry King, they asked her what was the mysterious illness that
she had, that she was originally released from jail the first time.
Right.
I suffer from claustrophobia my entire life.
So claustrophobia was the mystery
and,
illness.
When I first got in that cell, I was having severe panic attacks, anxiety attacks. My claustrophobia was kicking in.
Now, be right. You were in prison.
Oh yeah, I did a couple years.
how long did it take for your panic attacks and claustrophobia to set in?
It didn't.
And it didn't.
No.
Why is that? You're a stronger man.
You have to be stronger than that in your mind. I mean, you know, you did what you did, so go to jail and do the time for it.
But,
although I did count every little square in the screen.
All right.
But before B-Wright was sent away, he did not live in a multi-room mansion. I just think Paris was accustomed to much more freedom and more space than the rest of the prisoners.
B-Rod, you didn't tell the sheriff that you had claustrophobia, because if you did, he would have just let you out.
Wouldn't that have been great?
That's what they do. See, you didn't know that's what they do. If you tell them I have claustrophobia, that we had no idea, you can leave now.
No one's tried it.
I want you to try that if you ever get. I hope you never get picked up again. But if you do,
oh, he will.
Just you know, I have claustrophobia. Be right. We had no idea.
It was a very traumatic experience, young man. But I feel like God does make everything happen for a reason.
Stop that right there. Why does God take the blame for this? What did God do? God is good. There's no way God should be blamed for something like this. This is beyond. Divine intervention couldn't even help with this. And they shouldn't have let her out until she could spell claustrophobia. They should just, when you can spell it, then you can leave. And she do life.
Alonzo, thank you very much for coming in.
Thanks for having me on.
You can see Alonzo Bodden as a judge every week on Last Comic Standing, and you can also check him out while he is performing at Acting Comedy.
The B96 Tony Fly Morning Show.